Welcome everyone. Today we will explore DAX Query View, which is the latest addition to Power BI Desktop features by Microsoft. And along the way, we will also create a nice dashboard on the same dataset. So, let's get introduced to the DAX Query View. Previously we had three views: the report view, the table view, and the model view. But now, we also have the DAX Query View, which we will explore today and write some queries as well. First, let's load some data into the Power BI application. Click on the Excel workbook button and open the file you want to load. In the Navigator window, select the daily sales table and press the Load button to load the data into the Power BI. Once the table is loaded, it will appear in the data pane along with its fields, which can be used for visualization and analysis. Insert a text box at the top of the report and add an appropriate title for your dashboard. Select appropriate font size and add visual borders as well. Insert a line chart to your dashboard. Add the month field to the x-axis, sales field to the y-axis, and the profit field to the secondary y-axis. Duplicate the line chart and place it in the bottom left corner. Change it to a donut chart. Replace the date field with the salesperson field. And remove the profit field. Duplicate this chart and place it next to the existing one. Replace the sales field with the profit field. Again, duplicate this chart and place it at the bottom right corner. Replace the profit field with the purchase price field. Our dashboard is almost ready. We can also display the units sold information here. We can use a card visual for that. Now our dashboard is complete in all aspects. Back to our main topic, go to the DAX Query Viewer to create some queries and analyze this data using data analysis expression. In the DAX Query View, there is a predefined query which you can delete. In our first query, we will show you how to deal with queries generating single value as output. The define block is used to define variables. Define a variable named total sales. Calculate the total sales by taking the sum of sales field. The evaluate block displays the result in the table below. Enter the variable name here. Then run the DAX query. There is an error because the result is a single value, not a tabular data. We can use curly brackets to convert this single value into a table containing a single value. Now, run the query, and you should be able to display the resulting value in the table below. We used an aggregate function here, called sum. There are other aggregate functions as well, such as average. Average calculates the mean of data. We can display multiple items inside the curly brackets. Let's display both values in results. And here is the total sales and average sales as calculated above. Similarly, we can calculate maximum value as well, using the max aggregate function. We can include this value to our result as well. However, this is not the correct way to display multiple values. If values are not displayed in an order, you cannot tell which values is total, which is average, and which is maximum. One way to achieve this is to use multiple evaluate statements. To do that, we will create separate groups of each value, combined with its title. We will then use multiple evaluate statements, one to display each value. This will display total sales. This will display average sales. And the final evaluate statement will be used to display the maximum sales. When you run this query, there will not one, but three results, which you can view separately using this drop-down. Now, they won't mix up. We can also use the evaluate statement without the define statement. For example, we can use function named all to display the entire table. Or we can use the all except function to display all data except one or more columns. Let's exclude the date column and display all the others. We can also display the summarized data in the DAX query view. Let's define a variable and use the summarize function to display total sales by salesperson. Enter the name of the table, the group by column, which is salesperson. Enter the name for calculated column. And then enter the expression and select the column you want to summarize. We will use the evaluate statement to display the summarized table stored in variable X. And here is the result. Or we can display the average sales by salesperson. It is that easy. Now we have a proper query editor in Power BI for DAX as well. All your queries will remain saved with your file, and you can run them anytime to get the updated results. And here we end our tutorial. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more insightful tutorials and updates.